In this video lecture, we're going to focus on air mass classification. Air mass classification is very important because it determines what the quality of the air mass that's going to influence a particular region. And we're looking for the source region of these air masses. For example, air mass classification takes two components. It takes moisture and temperature. And where it is born. A particular air mass is born in a certain part of the geography. For example, in North America, if we consider North America, an air mass is born over the Gulf of Mexico. That is one source region. And we take the moisture availability and the quality of temperature and put those two together and we get a classification. So let's talk about these different abbreviations. If we have a lowercase m, if we could take this, a lowercase m, this equals marine environment, which is moist. So this is a moist air mass. On the opposite side of this, we get a lowercase c, and this is the abbreviation for continental, which is dry. It's a dry air mass. The air mass originates in a region over land, a continental type of air mass. So those are the only two qualifiers for moisture. You get marine air mass or you get a continental air mass. Now we'll add temperature to it and we get a couple of these. A capital T after moisture indicates that this is a tropical air mass, which is the temperature warm. If you have a capital P behind the abbreviation for moisture, then you get the polar air mass, which indicates that it is the relative temperature of cold. And then we get a third one, capital A, and this is Arctic. This is an Arctic air mass, and it is very cold. So let's take these abbreviations and put them together, and they'll mean something to us. And the proper procedure in putting these abbreviations together is that moisture goes first, lowercase, then temperature goes next in the capital. So we have a CP air mass, which is continental polar, which means dry, cold, originating over land. We have an MP air mass, which means moist and cold. Moist and cold. Moist and cold. Now, the two ways to differentiate this, and we'll talk about this in more detail here in a moment. A CP air mass usually originates in North America over central Canada. It is east of the Rockies. If you have an air mass over the North Pacific, then that is going to be a moist polar air mass. Okay, a moist cold air mass. Now that is west of the Rockies. East of the Rockies, west of the Rockies. These two air masses are indicated by the cold front. So if you have a cold front, that is west of the Rockies. These are the Rockies, the Rocky Mountains. Then that is going to be an MP air mass. And if you have a cold front that is east of the Rockies, then this is a CP air mass. You have west of the Rockies, the cold front indicates that this is an MP air mass. East of the Rockies, the cold front indicates that it is a CP air mass. CP air mass, cold and dry, wet and cold on this side. All right, let's move on to the next set of abbreviations. We have a moist tropical air mass. This is wet and warm. This air mass usually originates over the Gulf of Mexico. So it is an empty air mass is warm and moist, originating over the Gulf of Mexico. Or it can also originate over the South Pacific, or I should say southwest of California, over the Pacific. You get a CT air mass. This means continental tropical, which is dry and warm. This air mass originates over central regions of Mexico and the Southern Great Plains. While these two air masses, the CP and the MP, are indicated by a cold front, east of the Rockies, west of the Rockies, the MT air mass is always indicated by a warm front. The CT air mass is always indicated by a dry line front. So let's go ahead and have a look at the United States and where we can see these different air masses develop. If you look here, the circle in the central portion of Canada is a CP air mass and will move to the southeast. An MT air mass originates over the Gulf of Mexico and moves to the north or to the northeast. An MP air mass, indicated by a leading edge of the cold front, originates over the northwest Pacific and moves to the southeast. An MT air mass over just southwest of California will move to the northeast and influence California, Nevada, and Idaho. A CT air mass originates over Mexico and the Southern Great Plains and is indicated by a dry line front.